Glass is endlessly recyclable as long as the right kind and gets properly sorted. Old jars and bottles easily transform into new containers when they are separated into clear, brown and green glass. There is a saving of up to 20-30% of energy in recycling the glass rather than manufacturing a new one. So why often glass doesn't work to recycle? Americans dispose of some 10 million metric tons of glass annually. Most of it ends up in the trash. Only about 1/3 gets recycled. That's not because of some materials or chemical property that makes glass difficult to recycle. But the US is roughly 33% glass recycling rate, which pales compared with the 90% recycling rate in Switzerland, Germany, and other European countries, is not the result of a lack of technical know-how. We think of glass, aluminium, and plastic to be roughly equivalent to each other in terms of their functionality as a beverage container. There are some pros and cons to each depending on the specifics of application, but roughly equivalent and commonly used interchangeably. In order for this to be true from the bottle's perspective, they must be also fairly close in their cost per container. However, it is readily apparent that they are quite different in their mass per container, and dividing these two parameters gives us a value of cost per mass. This bounds the raw material cost plus manufacturing cost of container, and glass is clearly lower, equal cost slash higher mass. Glass is very cheap, it's basically made of sand and humans have been making and using it for thousands of years. Aluminium has really only become a useful material in the last 100 years, and it is extremely energy intensive to convert bauxite ore into usable metal. So aluminium is quite expensive per pound compared to other metals like steel and certainly compared to glass. Moreover, because of the expensive processing to create virgin aluminium, it is even more worthwhile to recycle aluminium because the processing isn't quite as difficult as creating new metal from ore. Transportation-wise, glass is mass-limited rather than volume-limited. An undamped semi-truck full to a typical 80,000-pound highway weight limit of broken glass cullet and typically be not much more than half full by volume, which means that the transportation fuel cost and driver cost per container will be higher than for other material that does not get weight limited. On the recycling side, one of the biggest competitors of recycled glass cullet is virgin raw materials. The cost of two materials at the glass furnace, including transportation, must be roughly at equilibrium, modulo some production efficiency trade-offs. However, the production scale of materials tends to be quite different. While virgin sand can be mined from well-established deposits and delivered directly to furnace, consumer recycled containers must be collected and hauled from many disparate sites, brought to a centralized facility for cleaning and sorting, and then hauled again, sometimes a short distance, sometimes quite far, to the furnace site. Again, in order to keep economic parity with the competing raw material, the value of recycled glass is forced low. Finally, at least in the United States, both glass container production and recycled glass processing are near monopolies. Within an economically reasonable hauling distance, there may only be one or zero outlets for recycled glass. If they are not willing to buy the recycled glass material you have in hand, its value can drop to zero or even negative if you start to look at the cost of land, warehouses to store it, or paying to haul and dispose of it in a landfill. This exerts some further economic pressures on glass recyclers that keeps the value down. If you like the video, give it a like and subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you do notify when I upload a new video. Thanks.